Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is ng News with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. The Angular compiler runs on top of the TypeScript compiler. That means that any change to TypeScript has a direct impact on Angular. Anders Hejlsberg, the lead architect of TypeScript at Microsoft, announced that they are porting the TypeScript compiler to Go. The TypeScript compiler was originally written in TypeScript itself, kind of eating your own dog food. The switch to Go doesn't mean that we have to learn Go now. Everything will stay the same, except that it's going to be faster. First numbers show 10 times faster and half of the memory consumption. So TypeScript is finally following a trend we've been seeing for many years. More and more tools are moving to languages that compile to native code. Think of esbuild, Rolldown, or Rspack. Go code compiles directly to machine code, which is optimized for the actual architecture. Unlike JavaScript that needs to be interpreted and partially compiled during runtime, native code is ready from the start. It also provides real concurrency, something we don't have in JavaScript. And a third reason that speaks for Go is that it is syntactically very close to JavaScript, which makes the port relatively easy. What do we get from it? Editors will respond much faster to our input, the build process will improve, and
we could also in a real-time manner check the output of AI to ensure that it is not just syntactically but also semantically correct. You keep the AI honest, so to speak, is to put it through a deterministic type checker.
The timeline? By the end of this year, the compiler should be fully functional, but that also means that other parts will not. And that includes, for example, project references, JS docs, but also the watch mode. And since the Angular compiler is so intermingled with the TypeScript compiler, I think that the Angular integration will take longer. We also had the Angular Q&A, a live stream, where this time Jessica Chinook, member of the Angular team, was explaining server-side rendering together with incremental hydration. As always, a lot of questions have been asked, and one of the big ones were what is, for example, the next feature in the area of server-side rendering.
Unless you're talking about like HTTP streaming on the server-side rendering side.
Oh yeah, good point. It's very different.
That is something that we are interested in working on. We just haven't been able to get there yet.
Another question was if we should always use the capabilities of defer with hydration together.
Hydration is a load time optimization. What makes sense? Is it initial load optimization you want to make? Incremental hydration are the way to go. But if there's other loading things that you want to add in, then you want to use that in combination with defer.
Since a lot of time of the stream focused on debugging issues, a reminder, be sure to turn off HMR in the dev mode if you want to see the behavior of the defer. In other news, two major Angular conferences have been confirmed for later this year. ng-conf is happening again, and Angular Connect, which used to be one of the largest Angular events, is making a comeback. And that's it. I wish you a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.